In lesson 2.4, students do an activity in which they see ice forming on the outside of a cold can. And the question is, why does that happen? What's going on with water vapor and temperature and water molecules that would allow water and then ice to form on the outside of a cold can? So the big ideas that we want students to get out of this is that freezing happens when the molecules of a liquid slow down enough so that their attractions bring them together and they form a crystal structure that's actually a little bit more spread out than water molecules are as a liquid. So let's take a look at how this works. The students will take a layer of salt and ice and salt and ice alternating like that until they fill their can up. Oh, and by the way, you should cover the can with layers, multiple layers of duct tape so that it's safe to handle. After they stir the ice and salt, they'll realize that there's a little bit of moisture on the can and also there's frost or ice. And the question is, what happened? Students should be able to have some good ideas about what's going on here because they've already seen that water vapor condenses and turns to a liquid on the outside of a cold glass, for instance. So this is one step further. If it's really cold, it'll actually turn to ice. And the idea that ice has a different arrangement, the water molecules in ice are actually further apart than they are in liquid water, is pretty interesting and can lead into lots of discussions of different things in nature and density and that sort of thing. We show kids the water molecules are close together in liquid water and further apart as the solid ice. On the student activity sheet, we want students to compare water and ice in different ways. The speed of the molecules, that they would be moving more slowly in ice than in water. They'll be vibrating in fixed positions in ice because they're in a crystal. That's the amount of movement. And the arrangement of the molecules is different in water and in ice. And there are pictures on the student activity sheet for students to write captions under to explain these kinds of characteristics of liquid water and solid ice. Also, in the teacher background area, if you go to this link right here, there's a section to help you kind of explain different aspects of the weather that has to do with evaporation, condensation, temperature, terms that students may have heard that they're not sure what they mean. Relative humidity, the dew point, what are the conditions for frost, for instance? So we have some information about that that you can share with students. Also, if you're in an NGSS state, there's a performance expectation, MSPS 1.4, which says develop a model that predicts and describes changes in particle motion, temperature, and state of a pure substance when thermal energy is added or removed. Well, lesson 2.4 relates to this performance expectation in that there's a thermal energy is being removed in this case. The water vapor is giving up or transferring energy to the very cold can. The water molecules are slowing down, condensing to a liquid, and then freezing to become ice. Also, if you look at the foundation boxes, students are doing the science and engineering practices here. They're developing a model. We've been doing that throughout chapters 1 and 2 to describe phenomena. For the disciplinary core ideas, it's all about changes of state. In this case, we're going from a gas, really, water vapor, to a liquid on the can, and then to frost or ice on the can. And then for cross-cutting concepts, for cause and effect, if the effect is that ice forms on the outside of a cold can, the cause is that there's water vapor molecules that are slowing down and condensing and then freezing. So these foundation boxes are dealt with in the lesson. So thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.